I'm Dana Denha, and this is Art Fair Close-Up 2018. I'm here with Susan Snook, and she's got some beautiful work. She looks like you're inspired a lot by nature, and you have functionality in your artwork.
I certainly do. I don't like anything that's not functional, practical, and I just enjoy the natural beauty of God's creation. It's just beautiful.
So how did you kind of get started as an artist, and what got you to this point?
Oh, that's a big question. I started off with decorative painting. I did faux finishes, murals, whatever. And then my daughter got married, so I went on to wedding cakes. And I thought, okay. And I started doing sculptured cakes. And I thought, this is crazy. People are buying like 3D giraffe cakes for Sweet 16, and I want it to last. So I took a class at the art gallery in Rochester, New York, and I learned how to do busts. I did Ronald Reagan and Abraham Lincoln, and then I knew I could sculpt, so I started doing the sculpting on the, which they showed me how to like hollow things out and how to put them together, and I paint, so I wanted to be able to take my love of painting and apply it to like the inside of bowls and stuff, and it's fully functional, so I enjoy it.
So are these just like normal glazes that you're using on clay, or?
I use stoneware clay. Most of my work is slab work, which is the difference. I do have, these are wheel thrown, but you can't add tree nubs to that. So these are slab work too. People like the look. It's fun. It's functional fun. So, but no, I'm enjoying the whole process, and I forgot what the question was, but no, but it's the glazes are, I layer my glazes. So, and I do a layer of black and I wash it off, and then the black bleeds through, so you can see how it bleeds through. And I carve and I sculpt and I add white and I take things off and put things back on, and then I add a clear glaze, and it's fired twice, so.
It's very unique. That's why I was wondering about the glazing process, because I've never seen anything quite like it, and it really does have like that tree feel, like it feels like you're looking at a tree.
I was happy with that, because when I first, this is my third full year, and when I first started, my nephew had gotten married, so I thought, well, let me just try a vase. And I sculpted his initials on it with his wife-to-be's old initials. And when it came out of the kiln, it looked like a tree bark. And I was so excited. I said, this is it.
Do you find yourself in nature a lot? Like just looking?
I love the outdoors. I should focus more, but I'm always looking out to my backyard with the trees and the birds and then the nuthatches and the chickadees. They're such fun birds to watch. And people enjoy them, and they like my work. So I'm having fun doing it.
Yeah, and you got a lot of stuff that you can use in the kitchen, but you got candle holders and stuff like that.
And it's all coming little by little. I listen to the customers. They'll say, you know, it would be nice if you had this, but if you had this on, I would buy it. And I'm like, okay, well, let me try it. And so following year, this is my third full year, and I've got a couple new things, so it's working for me, so people are enjoying it.
Awesome. Do you have a website?
Yes, I do, snookceramics.com.
All right, well, I can't wait to see what's next for you, because I think your work is just gorgeous.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for more from the Ann Arbor Art Fairs. Thank you.